ClickUp calls itself the everything application, and for many people, it's becoming that in the project management space. And they're adding features like nobody's business. It is just always seeming to grow as a tool. Now, you're probably wondering, is it the everything app? And is it something that I can rely on as a project management software for me and my team, or as a managing it as a freelancer or contractor trying to keep yourself organized? Today, we're going to break down ClickUp and give you an idea of all of the features. We're going to see what's available on the free plan and a breakdown of all of those elements to help get you started and to really understand this application as a whole. Today's video is kindly sponsored by Zapier. We'll hear more about them later in this video. So here we are with ClickUp. And one of the first things that you need to know is this is available everywhere. It's got an app on pretty much every single device, meaning you can get it on mobile, even on things like Linux, with a Chrome extension and much more. This application is super accessible, meaning it is very much the everything app. Now you can download it below if you're interested as we progress with this video, but we're going to explore initially the pricing. The pricing for ClickUp is that you get a free plan. That free plan is limited to 100 megabytes of storage across the account. Now, you can add other people to it, but the free plan will quickly run out, as you can imagine, which means there are other additional pricings with more features included. Those will appear on screen now, and this changes quite dramatically over the period of time. So just be aware that some of the features that we mention will be included in those premium pricings, but not in all of them. So just be aware of which plan suits you, whether you need timesheets, whether you need roadmaps for timeline functions, and what plan is suitable for you. So this white here is ClickUp, and it is, for a lot of people, was previously fairly overwhelming. They've cleaned the things up since their last sort of update in the 3.0 version, which is what we've got in front of us today. It is a lot more easier to manage. Before, it was quite overwhelming. And let's show you one of the first things that is a lot more approachable, and that is this home area. Now, the home area is much more consistent with being a workspace for you to land on. And it's a great way for you to organize different elements of your day and make sure that you're keeping updated with it. So here on the left-hand side, you can see your recents. But as you can see here, if I click down, I can drag things to the different areas in which I want to see. So this is almost like a dashboard for you to manage and optimize. And there's even an AI features that are baked in here, like the stand-up feature, which can help produce a stand-up, more of a development practice, but something that might help to overview and prepare you for the day ahead. Now here you can see I've got calendar, I've got even reminders, which I can add to tasks, and you can pretty much organize this however you find best suited to you, collectively structured by the account that you have access to. Ever wanted to automate things, but you lack the coding skills? You can now do that with Zapier with no code. Zapier is the leader in automation, allowing you to take your workflows to the next level with a suite of automation tools. You can go from an idea to reality in no time, setting up triggers for simple workflows and for even more advanced ones. That's why over 2.2 million companies use and trust Zapier. And thanks to Zapier for sponsoring this video. Now, this is where, over here, the spaces organize all of the features we're going to talk about in this video. So spaces is essentially a large folder for a large folder if you want it to, for all of the projects and the documents that you may have as part of what you're working with as a team. You can view all of the spaces or create a brand new space with an icon, a name, and a description to kick things off. So here is an example of what one of the projects looks like in ClickUp. And I think the first thing I want to start with talking about is tasks. So the good thing about ClickUp's abilities with tasks is they're pretty customizable. Now, this is what a task looks like. If I click into it, I can add a fair bit of detail. I can add things like time estimates, all the way to the relationship to other tasks, all the way to priority. I can see an activity sheet. I can see and add additional functions to this, like linking tasks, waiting on, blocking. And that can be quite overwhelming because you're trying to grasp what this can do. Well, very simply, you can add subtasks to it, checklists, and you can get working on the task itself. Each of the tasks has this weird number associated with it, and it's called an ID. It essentially allows you to embed it in other areas as part of the application. But many people find that this is a good way to organize what they need to do, and you can even use AI to help you these days. For example, with the ClickUp AI, you can help it generate the name and details of that. So for example, I can add a short description based on the task title. I can generate subtasks as part of the task detail. Now, let me explain to you how this looks, because tasks are helpful. You can add a lot of detail to them, but the power comes from something called views. Now, views are essentially ways to express your tasks in different ways. So for example, you've got a board, Kanban view, which you can drag stuff across. You can add an additional group. You can really customize this in quite a high level of detail. So if I go to customize, as you can see on this right-hand side, maybe quite overwhelming as we're watching this video, you can do all sorts of things. Use templates, groups, filters, sorting. I won't go through them all because it's almost like a database function. You pretty much know how you can customize it to you and your team. So there might be that one person in a team who takes control of this and gets things organized before you get rolling. Now up here, you can also change a view to a list view. Now this is more common if you're moving across from another software like monday.com, and they essentially allow you to break things down and see everything quite visually. So from here, I could add a due date, I could assign it to another person, and I could quickly add comments to this. So I can add maybe a note to somebody in my team, assigning it to them, or maybe giving them a bit of context for the task. But really, this is like more of a bird's eye view of your list and all of the attributes to it and where they belong. Now, there is a calendar view, and this one is more popular with those who are more zoom out, even more zoom out than lists. You can see stuff more visually based on a day, and you can change what attribute this is associated to. So you could have it as a due, whether it's due date, whether it's a start date, or another custom date that you might find suitable. So this could be great for content planning, for being able to see what you and your team are working on in terms of launches. It's really up to you. But there is a more powerful view called Gantt view. Many people know what a Gantt chart is, so I will not explain that. And what you can do is add all of the elements into the Gantt view and make them bigger. You can also create subtasks as part of that and schedule the time that you want to focus on them based on other attributes as well. Now, why is this really nice? Because a lot of people like to see this in a month view or a quarter view, and all of the team can see where each project is heading and when it's going to finish, ideally. So here you can also view something called a table view. It's pretty much what it says on the tin. And then you've got a whole host of additional views. And I'm going to talk just about the task management help, which can be helpful. So what we're going to look at is the next thing is workload. Now, workload is in particularly helpful for seeing who's assigned work and how long they're spending on it. So I can choose a person in my team. In this case, it's me. And I can see all of my team. So as a manager, this can be a really effective view for you. So I can then go in here and I can see, okay, they've got this much capacity per day. It looks like I'm fairly free next week. But that allows you to see, once adding the time estimates to each of your tasks, is one of my team members suffering? And then that resource management, you can reallocate tasks to other people in your team to be more effective and smarter as a manager. So there are additional views like timeline view. Now this is slightly different to a Gantt view. It's more or less structured like with task dependencies, and it gives you the flexibility to see stuff at a more approachable view. So maybe less intense than like a Gantt view, but more easy to access if you're somebody that doesn't know how to use Gantt. Now here you've also got an additional view called mind map. And this is a great way to see all of the tasks that you have as part of your workload. Now I can open the tasks up and I can add tasks on and break them down even further. Why is this helpful? Well, this gives you a better perspective of your tasks if you're a visual thinker. So this way you can then break down tasks and see them in more detail or see what stage you're currently working on. Now, a lot of people like this view because it helps give them a more generalized visual demonstration of how their tasks are being adapted. And you can also modify other details such as templates, and you can browse some templates as well as refining what this exactly looks like. So that was a powerful look at the ClickUp tasks. They're quite extensive inside this application, as you can imagine, but they have another layer of part of your ClickUp account called documents. And this allows you to bring the knowledge of your team into one location. And what I quite like about it is how easy it is to use. So here is a project notes that I have, and I can, for example, start working away. I can mark it as an internal wiki. Now, an internal wiki is a great way for you and your team to manage knowledge that is more consistent. Stuff that's going to stick around for 6 months to 12 months, whatever it may be. But this allows you to have a data resource so that a new employee can come in and find that information. So you can create a blank wiki. You could, for example, use one of their templates that are part of that. You can do a lot of things with documents. You can embed a new page, you can embed a table, you can link a task, which could be a powerful way to see information, or you could choose one of their wide-ranging templates. So here's what one of these templates looks like. And if you're, say, starting out a wiki for your branding and guidelines, and you just want to be able to have everything in one location, you can go into this and formulate the information that people need. And why is this helpful? Well, you can not only use this with new employees that sharing this as a resource without using something like Docs and changing other applications. But the benefit to this is that you can use this in the bottom right-hand corner. Now, for new employees that maybe have a lot of questions but don't want to overload managers on their first day, they may want to ask something. So for example, they may say, why is it important to establish brand values or brand colors in your brand book? To be able to ask a question that's helpful to learn. And you can see here that it's also breaking down knowledge from the web, but also from the document to be able to establish all the information you need to know. And that's incredibly helpful for breaking down barriers and asking questions. Now, as you can see, the documents you can connect up to tasks or relations. You can even modify all of the information, including protecting the document and seeing how it looks, as well as statistics about it, how long it's going to take you to read. You can go into each of the projects and actually have a document in line, which will allow you to modify information while still being in this view and to be able to see and quickly. You can quickly down here. So one of the things you can do is put it inside of your tray down here, which means you can quickly access it at any given point, quickly add some information to it as you're working on the project. So inside of ClickUp, you also have the ability as a team to replace potentially the likes of Slack or Microsoft Teams. And this is called chat. Now, chat isn't necessarily the most attractive option. Neither do I think it's a full replacement to Slack. But what it might do is get you 80% of the way there and reduce the cost that you may have if you want to implement something like Slack in a team. So here you can see posts. So for example, this could be a company update or brief message to all of the team. And this is a good way to update other people. You can also add announcements, ideas, and discussions where people can comment and interact below. And what's nice inside of here is you can also add tasks, documents, and whiteboards as a way to begin collaborating on an idea or just giving context to the context that you have posted about. Now here you can also see follow-ups, and this is a great way to see assigned messages to you and any reminders associated to you as well. You can also see activity and drafts that you're preparing to send. But most importantly, there's an area called channels. Now, channels allows you to chat about the latest information that you and your team are working on. And you can even see the posts that have been connected to and any boards that are associated to the workspace that you've connected it to. This is great if you just want to jump into the workload and be able to start collaborating as a team together. You can also direct message people if you find it suitable, and you can view this in the calendar as well as a way to see when you've got an upcoming date or you do not want to potentially connect with that. This is also a helpful feature if you're looking for any tasks that are associated to the person you're communicating with. Why is that important? Well, if you want to see a more personalized view of what that looks like, then this is a great way to see that. I can see that as I'm working with this person, they have right report that I have assigned to that person. So very helpful for managers to see how the workload's going and to process that. So inside of ClickUp, as part of the very basic plan, you get a simple dashboard. There are some more powerful ones like team reporting, time tracking, project management, and other abilities. So I can create a dashboard for any of the project areas that I am working on. And you can see here how it creates this instantly. Now, this is a great way to zoom out and see how the project is progressing. Now, why are dashboards helpful? Well, you can edit them, which means you can modify the structure of them, but you can also add in useful information that is happening in real time with your ClickUp account. Now, this is particularly helpful if you are doing a weekly call. If you want to see a big zoom out of how you and your team are operating, then this could be a great way to do that. You could see all of the latest activity. But I've seen it most used with companies that have data being imported to their dashboard. I've seen this in other companies like Monday and other companies that have dashboard functionality. And it's a great way to see live data that you and your team are working towards. So you can progressively see the integrations working with this, which is a helpful way to collaborate. So let's take a look at goals. Goals are a great way to see a particular target you're working on and how much progress you've been making towards them. So for example, you can create a target that is part of an existing goal. You can also set information about it, and you can have sharing of permissions with particular team members. Now, this is a way to break down a task. For example, you could say landing page, because that's the target. You can choose an owner, and you can naturally go and find a specific set of work that you are doing, like review spend, that you want to be able to associate to this to see whether the task is or goal is completed. You can see all of your goals and how you're progressing towards them. Just one of the things to note is that this isn't particularly as useful as the way that the tasks operate inside of projects as part of the ClickUp account. It does have some functionality, but not as useful as how tasks work. So one of the final things that you can do in ClickUp, there are even more, is whiteboards. And whiteboards are a great way to collaborate on tasks or documents, or even visualize elements that you're working on. So in this case, I can use some of the templates that are available. For example, if I wanted to use this benchmark analysis and be able to drag in tasks from something I'm working on, then this is what I can do. This is a helpful way for me to use templates, but also have the inclusion of tasks in there. I could even do things like adding post-it notes and even adding shapes. I can also add in documents that I have created that I maybe want to attribute and use in real time so that I can have the knowledge to be able to modify the details on here. So it's an all-in-one type experience for managing whiteboards. Now, in my opinion, this isn't as good as more dedicated platforms like Lucidchart and like even Concept Board or Miro as a replacement to a whiteboard application. But what's nice is it's very much the everything experience to bake into how you're managing and visualizing workload. So zooming out as part of this video, ClickUp is a really helpful resource for being able to manage all of the aspects of your work. And for many people, being able to get 80% of the way there with having things like the mind mapping, the whiteboard, the documents, the chat inside of and housed next to your project management can sometimes be the difference between using an app and getting stressed with an app. Some people don't want to use lots of different apps and jump across them. So ClickUp's trying to solve that problem. Does it do a good job? I think it does a fairly good job. It isn't going to replace if you're an avid Miro user. It isn't going to replicate those elements because that app is very much refined and a very thorough process for doing it. But if you are using, say, Miro, and you're not maybe paying for it, or you're not maybe capitalizing on all of the features, then something like ClickUp Whiteboards might actually be a solution for you. But it is also something that does implement a lot of traditional project management setups, which you may be well happy with. So thank you so much for stopping by in this video. If you're interested in ClickUp, you can find it linked below. But largely, it is a powerful all-in-one application that wants to help you host everything in one spot. If you're interested in more reviews of tools and project management softwares, then you could jump over to toolfinder.co to explore more. A big thanks to Zapier for sponsoring today's video, and I look forward to helping you with more reviews and resources in the future. And if you're interested, you can subscribe here on the channel. So thanks very much. Make sure to have a great day, and I'll talk to you very soon, I'm sure. Cheerio for now.